हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेकंड ईयर कॉमर्स क्लास। अगेन वी हैव स्विच्ड इनटू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। अनफॉर्चुनेटली दिस कोविड सेकंड वेव अफेक्टेड अवर ऑफलाइन क्लासेस। स्टिल वी आर लकी दैट वी हैव फिनिश्ड मैक्सिमम पोर्शन थ्रू ऑफलाइन। वी कुड रिवाइज द प्रीवियस ऑनलाइन क्लासेस, those contents and some part of majority part of problematic part, that is accountancy, has been done through offline mode. So the almost two months classes what we have conducted through offline mode were very effective. I hope most of you have learnt the subject well. Exams will go on as per the schedule. Don't think that the exams may be postponed. Exams will be conducted. It is only temporary shutdown of educational institutions to avoid spreading of corona and to safeguard the students. By May, everything will be settled, as already people are getting vaccinated. So this time exams will be there. Don't have that negative thinking of cancellation of exams, without exams will be promoted, all that. Okay. And in this class, Commerce second year, today we are going to discuss very important 2 marks questions. As already in class, I have explained you the importance of 2 marks in the commerce paper. Those who are aiming at 98-99 marks, for them 2 marks play a very, very important role. Even for the below average students also, to be in the safe zone, to cross over that border of 35, 2 marks play a very, very important role, because it is easy to by heart. The people who are struggling in communication, spellings, etc., for them by hearting the long answers and essay questions may be difficult for them, those who are having poor communication skills. So the students who are struggling in communication can learn these 2 marks very easily, because these are only 2 to 3 lines answers. Even if it is 70-80% relevant, will be given full marks. Okay, so I suggest all of you to focus on these 2 marks well. You will be having 10 marks in commerce and 10 marks in accountancy. Okay. Previously, you used to be given 8 questions, out of which you had to write 5. Now you will be given 10 questions. Due to this COVID pandemic, the Board of Intermediate has modified the question paper pattern. Okay, someday I will give that class also through online mode. So third section, you used to be given 8 questions earlier. Now you are given only 10 questions, out of which you have to write 5. Each question carries 2 marks. So that's how we can score 10 marks. So regarding the very important 2 marks questions, some already we have done in offline class. Still we are repeating through online mode. The first one is derivatives. Derivative is something which generates income by your investment. As you all know that many times during my online class and offline classes, I have told, when we require finance from the people, we have to issue so many documents. Some agreement should be there between the entrepreneur and the investor, so that investor can give his money to the entrepreneur or to those joint stock companies or any financial institution expecting some reward. So we have got so many documents like shares, debentures, bonds, commercial papers, okay, mutual funds, etc., etc. So everything has got some special features and rewards. So among them, first one is derivatives. So derivatives are defined by Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956. That is, a contract which derives its value from the prices or index of prices of underlying securities. Suppose you have purchased a security, that means a share or some debenture, for 100 rupees. Now its value increases to 120 rupees. Okay. Then a security derived from a debt instrument, share, loan, whether secured or unsecured, risk instrument or contract or any form of security. That means by investing your money, you will get some reward. Then Second question is forwards. A forward is a contract where the agreement between two parties to buy or sell an asset at an agreed price in future. These contracts are special types of forwards contract and are traded through exchange in standardized process. It means, for example, this pad is there. So as on 27th March, I will agree with the management that I will buy this pad in the month of May at a price of 100 rupees. Forward means in future. So I am deciding the future price of a security here, not for product, of a security in advance. So that's how the agreement is made between the two stock exchange operators or two brokers or between the investor and the broker. That means in the future, whether price increases or decreases, the concerned person has to issue the security at an agreed price, whatever they have agreed, whatever they have came to the conclusion. For example, Reliance company share today is 500 rupees. In future it may become 600 or maybe 350. But I will enter into an agreement with a stock broker that in the month of May, I will buy 100 shares of Reliance company at a price of 500 rupees each. That's it. That means in the month of May, I will pay 100 into 500, 50,000, then I will get 100 shares. Whether the share becomes 5,000 or 400, increases or decreases, that doesn't affect. So that is what called as forward. Option is derivatives contract between two parties to buy or sell specified number of shares at a later date for an agreed price. It is usually regarded as the right but not the obligation to buy or sell something. Options are divided into two types, such as calls and puts option. That means you will enter into an agreement to buy the share at an agreed price, but it is your wish. Option means you may buy or may not buy. Later on you can deny also. That means if you are not interested, you can come out of that contract. But if you want to buy, you have to pay that agreed price. Swaps are private contract between two parties to exchange cash flows in future according to a pre-agreed formula. The amount of cash flows is based on the rate of interest. They can be considered portfolios of forward contract. That means, as you all know, that rate of interest also may be fluctuating in the market. As you see that even the banks also, they change the rate of interest on loans and deposits. So here swap means both parties will come into an agreement that in future how much they want to pay the rate of interest. Then mutual fund. This is already discussed in the class. When a single investor is not able to invest his money in a joint stock company or in any financial market, some organization, some fund manager will collect small amounts from different parties and pool up that money. That money is invested into some organization in the form of debentures or in the form of other investment. So they are called as units. So once those companies earn money, after deriving that profit, this profit will be distributed among all these investors. So whatever we buy is called as unit. Normally when we buy shares, you are called as shareholder. So mutual fund, mutual means helping each other. So here a single person cannot contribute for the capital. Single person do not know how to invest his money. So smaller amounts are collected from large people. A person, a organization, collectively that amount is investing into the capital of some joint stock company. Once the profits are derived, earned from that company, these are again divided among the investors. So once the company earns profit, then only these fund owners or say the investors will get some amount. If the company incurs losses, you won't get anything. That is the reason mutual funds are subjected to market risk. Most of the times you may be going through the TV ad. ICICI mutual funds, Bajaj Alliance, various companies are coming out with various mutual funds nowadays. So you can see that after the ad, they will tell mutual funds are subjected to market risk. Then open ended fund. Open ended funds are available for subscription and repurchase through the year. These funds allow the investors to buy or sell units at net asset value related prices. The main feature of open ended funds are liquidity, but it does not have a fixed maturity period. Means throughout the year, open ended funds means anytime you can invest and anytime you can sell off. You do not have a fixed period, like you need to invest 274 days, 90 days, 45 days, 360 days, like that. Fixed duration is not there. You can invest that money for 10 days, 15 days, 20 days. As long as you are interested to keep your investment in such company, you can continue, or in that financial market. Once you feel that it is not profitable, you can withdraw your capital. That is called open-ended fund. Then growth funds. Growth funds are also called as nest eggs or long-haul investments. These funds have the principal objective of capital appreciation in the value of underlying investment over a period of time. These funds invest in growth-oriented securities like shares of companies which can be appreciated in long run. Normally, many times I told you during my classes, people, that means the investors, have got different mindset. Some people require regular income in short run. Some people require regular income in long run. Some people, they don't expect the return, but they expect the value of their investment increase. Suppose if some people are like, if they invest their money in Reliance company, they expect that every year they get dividend. Some people are like, even though they don't get dividend every year, the value of the share must increase. So 100 rupees share should become 200, 200 rupees share must become 400, like that they expect. So these are called as growth funds. Then commercial bill. Clearly on board I have mentioned this. Commercial bill means it is a negotiable instrument which is drawn by the seller on the buyer. Because many times I told you that in the market you need to give credit. If you sell goods on credit basis, unfortunately the debtor did not turn up and pay the money, you will be in trouble. So you need to have some security for collection of your debts. So what we have to do? We have to enforce the debtor to make the payment on a stipulated date. So that is the reason the seller will write a document on the buyer that you have to pay certain sum of money after the specified period. So we are making the debtor to make the payment. We are committing him. So commercial bill is a negotiable instrument drawn by the maker. Who is the maker? Means who draws the bill? That is called seller. So as he is making the bill, he becomes drawer. The person on whom we are writing is called as drawee. So there will be a specified amount, specified duration. So after that time period, the debtor has to make the payment. That is called honoring of bill. Then permitted securities. Apart from listed securities, permitted securities are allowed to deal in stock exchanges. Permitted securities refer to the securities which are not listed in specified stock exchange but are freely traded in other stock exchange. Normally, while explaining the lesson of stock exchange, I told you that all shares of all companies are not to be traded in the stock exchange. In order to trade our securities in the stock exchange, we have to go for listing. For listing, what we have to do? There are some formalities like providing your documents like Memorandum of Association, Articles of Association, past 5 years, financial reports like profit and loss account and balance sheet copies are to be submitted. Then you have to give an underwriting to the stock exchange that you will follow the guidelines, regulations of stock market, etc. Some fees is to be paid. Once this is done, the stock exchange will permit you to trade your securities. That is called listing of securities. Sometimes, some stock exchanges, even though your shares are not listed in the stock exchange, they will permit you to trade your securities on the official floor of stock exchange. They are called as permitted securities. Then money at call. So this also already we have discussed. It is a very short term loan given only for 7 days by bankers particularly it is a mutual adjustment between the two banks, or sometimes stock brokers are also given these type of loans from the commercial banks, where you have to pay that money within a period of 7 days. Then comes credit card. Okay, this also we have already discussed. Credit card is a card issued by the bank to its customer, allowing the customer to buy any goods or to buy services even though he does not have cash in his account. On behalf of customer, the bank will make the payment. So within the stipulated time period, the customer has to repay that money to the bank. So simply through credit card, the bank of the customer is assuring the seller that you provide goods or services to my customer, on behalf of my customer I will make the payment. So bank is assuring the customer, okay, that it will take care of the payments. Later on it will collect from the customer. That is called credit card. Then term loan, where we take loan from various banks and we agree to pay for after 6 months or 1 year, 5 years, 10 years. So these are called as term loans. Term is time period. As you know, all the installments what we are availing for car loan, house loan, these are all called as term loans. Foreign banks, as you all know that foreign banks are not registered under the Companies Act 1956. They are registered outside India and had introduced in a foreign country. Okay, these are the banks which deal with accepting deposits and lending loans. Their main objective is to earn profit and shareholders value. Then demand loan. Demand loan means the banker provides you loan, but as soon as the banker demands, you have to pay back. Okay, there is no time period for that. In term loan, we had the time for 5 to 15 years. But in demand loan, the banker is not allowing you the time. Suppose today, as on 27th March, you have taken 10,000 rupees loan from Andhra Bank or say some State Bank of India. After 1 week, immediately the banker informs you that you please repay your loan. Then you have to pay. So that is what called as term loan, as a demand loan. Generally, these demand loans are granted for short term period. Demand loans are granted on the security of Kisan Vikas Patra or life insurance policy. Then mobile banking. Mobile banking, as you all know that banking through your mobile phones, where SMS alerts are sent by the bank through the customer whenever you deposit or withdraw cash or make some payments. Some amounts are credited or debited. So regarding any transaction taken place in your account in a bank, that has been informed to the customer through the mobile messages. This is called as mobile banking. So using mobile, you can go for internet banking also. You can transfer money, as nowadays you are getting so many options and apps through which you can facilitate the banking transactions. Then comes leadership. As you all know, leadership is to guide others. Here in terms in commerce, don't think leadership as a quality of politics. Here, leadership refers to where in an organization you have got the capacity to influence your subordinates. You have the capacity to motivate your juniors, and you can inspire them. You can convince them to work, and you guide them, you direct them to work. This is called as leadership. Then enterprise. So any business organization or a corporation or any firm which carries out some economic activities in order to earn profit is called as enterprise. Then the last one is balanced regional development. As you all know that it is the responsibility of the government and the entrepreneurs to see that all areas of the country or of the state are equally developed. If the regions are not uniformly developed, that leads to imbalanced development and further rift in the society. So there are so many problems we have to face if all regions are not uniformly or equally developed. So balanced regional development means development of industries or say infrastructure facilities in all the areas of a country or state. Okay, that means all people of our country should be benefited with the development fruits. If only one area is developed and other regions are neglected, so the people from the neglected area may start revolution against the government authorities and against the other part of the society. So we have to see that all areas are equally developed.